Hello everyone. Today our topic in discrete math course is sequences and summations. First, sequences. A sequence is a discrete structure used to represent an ordered list. It's a function from a subset of the set of integers, usually either the set 0, 1, 2, etc., or the set 1, 2, 3, etc., to a set S. We use the notation an to denote the image of the integer n. We call an term of the sequence. Notation to represent sequence is an in curly brackets. It's the same notation used to represent sets. We distinguish between them by the context in which they are used. Consider, for example, the sequence an, where an equals 1 over n. The list of the terms of this sequence beginning with a1 are a1, a2, A3, etc. Starts with 1, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, etc. Or we can write 1, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, etc. Or the sequence AN, where AN equals 1 over N. N is the set of positive integers. Another example. The sequence 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, etc. equals an, where an equals 2 to the power 2, where small n belongs to capital N, the set of natural numbers. And the sequence 1 to the power 2, 2 to the power 2, 3 to the power 2, 4 to the power 2, etc. is the sequence an, where an equals n to the power 2, n belongs to z plus. Some common sequences are n square 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, etc., n cube 1, 8, 27, etc., n to the power 4, 2 to the power n, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, etc., 3 to the power n, 3, 9, 27, 81, etc., n factorial 1, 2, 6, 24, 120, etc. Next, we'll discuss two types of important sequences, arithmetic and geometric progressions. First, arithmetic progression. An arithmetic progression is a sequence of the form A, A plus D, A plus 2D, etc., A plus ND, where the initial term A and the common difference D are real numbers. An arithmetic progression is a sequence where each term, except the first term, is obtained by adding a fixed number to its previous term. Or also we can say that an arithmetic progression is a sequence where the differences between every two consecutive terms are the same. For example, 1, 5, 9, 13, etc. has the initial term A equals to 1, the first term, and the common difference D equals 5 minus 1, or 9 minus 5, or 13 minus 9, etc., which is 4. So in an arithmetic progression, A plus D, A plus 2D, etc., the common difference is A2 minus A1, or AI plus 1 minus AI. The nth term of an arithmetic progression can be obtained as AN equals A, the initial term, plus N minus 1 multiplied by D. The sum of the first N terms of an arithmetic progression is Sn equals N over 2 multiplied by 2A plus N minus 1 multiplied by D. This formula is used when the nth term is not known. When the nth term An is known, the sum of the first N terms of an arithmetic progression is Sn equals n over 2 multiplied by a1 plus an. For example, given the progression minus 1, 3, 7, 11, etc., find the 20th element and which term is 139. In this sequence, the initial term a equals minus 1 and the common difference d equals 3 minus minus 1, which is 4, or 7 minus 3, or 11 minus 7, etc. A20 equals minus 1 plus n minus 1 20 minus 1 multiplied by d, which is minus 1 plus 19 multiplied by 4, which is 40 plus 36, 76 minus 1, 75. To find which term is 139, an equals 139. In the formula, an equals a plus n minus 1 multiplied by d, 139 equals minus 1 plus n minus 1 multiplied by 4. And this is equals to minus 1 plus 4n minus 4. 4n equals 139 plus 5, 144. N equals 144 over 4, which is 36, which means 139 is the element 36. And if we want to find the sum of the first 20 elements, Sn equals n over 2 multiplied by 2a plus n minus 1d. Sn, the sum of the first 20 elements, equals 20 over 2, 10, multiplied by minus 2 plus 19 multiplied by 4. And the result is 10 multiplied by 76 minus 2, 74. So the sum of the first 20 elements is 740. Next, geometric progression. A geometric progression is a type of sequence where each succeeding term is produced by multiplying each preceding term by a fixed number, which is called a common ratio. This progression is also known as a geometric sequence of numbers that follow a pattern, A, AR, AR to the power 2, etc., AR to the power n, where the initial term A and the common ratio R are real numbers. An example of a geometric sequence is 2, 4, 8, 16, etc., where the common ratio is 2. The general form of geometric progression is A, AR, AR to the power 2, AR to the power 3, etc., where A is the first term, R the common ratio, AN the nth term. The nth term of geometric progression is given by AN equals AR to the power n minus 1. When we divide any succeeding term from its preceding term, then we get the value equal to the common ratio. The formula for the nth term of the geometric progression is AN equals AR to the power n minus 1. Again, A is the first term, R is the common ratio, N is the number of the term which we want to find. Next, regarding the sum. If the number of terms in a geometric progression is finite, then the sum of the geometric series is calculated by the formula. Sn equals A multiplied by 1 minus R to the power N over 1 minus R. This formula, if R is not equal to 1. If R equals 1, then Sn equals A multiplied by N. Again, A is the first term, R the common ratio, N is the number of the terms in the series. If the number of terms in a geometric progression is infinite, an infinite geometric series sum formula is used. In infinite series, there arise two cases depending upon the value of R. Case 1, if the absolute value of R is less than 1. In this case, the sum equals A over 1 minus R. The second case, when the absolute value of R is greater than 1. In this case, the series does not converge and it has no sum. Example, in a certain culture, the count of bacteria get doubled after every hour. There are 3 bacteria in the culture initially. What would be the total count of bacteria at the end of the 10th hour? The number of bacteria forms a geometric progression where the first term A equals 3 and the common ratio R equals 2. So the total number of bacteria at the end of the 10th hour will be the sum of the first 10 terms of this progression given by S10 equals A 3 multiplied by R 2 to the power N, which is 10 or minus 1, all over R 2 minus 1. This is equals to 3 multiplied by 2 to the power 10, 1024 minus 1, 1023 over 1, which is 3069 bacteria. A lot of them so quickly. For today, that's all. Thank you.